हेलो भाई, वेलकम टू एनवायरमेंटल पॉल्यूशन। सो टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट एनवायरमेंटल पॉल्यूशन, ऑल द डायमेंशंस ऑफ एनवायरमेंटल पॉल्यूशन सच एज एयर पॉल्यूशन, वाटर पॉल्यूशन, सॉइल कंटेमिनेशन, थर्मल पॉल्यूशन, नॉइज पॉल्यूशन एंड रेडियोएक्टिव मटेरियल्स। सो First of all, we have to define the pollution. What is pollution? Pollution is presence of unwanted material, which is known as pollution. It may be in air, then it called as air pollution. Maybe in soil, it may call as soil contamination. Maybe in water, then it is known as water pollution. So, pollution is the effect of undesirable changes in our surroundings that have harmful effects on plants, animals, and human beings. Okay, so water pollution, first of all, come to the water pollution. Water pollutants, which have major part for the pollution, first of all, those are degradable or non-persistent pollutants, means though can be those materials which can be degrade easily. So those are in this category. For example, domestic sewage, discarded vegetables, etc. And then slowly degradable or persistent pollutants remain this category in the environment for many years in unchanged or unchanged conditions and take decades or longer to degrade, such as DDT and some kinds of plastics. Then non-degradable pollutants means these unwanted materials or the pollutants cannot be degraded by natural process. Once they are released into the environment, they are difficult to eradicate and continue to accumulate. For example, toxic elements like lead or mercury, these cannot be removed easily. Now, air pollution. So, again, you can say unwanted materials or unwanted gases present in air will be known as air pollution. So you can define it necessary for existence. Air is compulsory for existence. It is a colorless, odorless mixture of gases. Quality of air varies in different environments, urban and rural. Emission of particulated matters from anthropogenic means man-made sources such as industry vehicles, and natural sources, volcanoes, forest fires, etc. Composition of air, can see 78% part of the air mixture is nitrogen, then 21% of this total mixture part is oxygen, and then remaining major part is carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, and then rest of other gases. Pollutants include, the pollutants are solid, liquid, or gaseous substances which are present in this air. So average human requires near about 12 kg of air each day, which is nearly 12 to 15 times greater than the amount of food we eat. Thus, even a small concentration of pollutants in the air becomes more significant in comparison to the similar level present in food. Means air pollution is more harmful than the food or the water pollution. Now, What is air pollution? The presence of undesirable solids, gases, or liquids in air is air pollution, as we have told you earlier. Air may get polluted by natural causes such as volcanoes, which release ash, dust, sulfur, and other gases, or by forest fires. However, unlike pollutants from human activity, naturally occurring pollutants tend to remain in the atmosphere for a short time and do not lead to permanent atmospheric changes. Pollutants that are emitted directly from identifiable and unidentifiable sources are produced both by natural events, for example, dust storms, volcano explosions, and human activities, emission from vehicles and industries, etc. So these are called as primary pollutants. And the secondary pollutants, the pollutants that are produced in the atmosphere when certain chemical reactions take place among the primary pollutants are called as secondary pollutants. Particulates. In air, the small particles of solid materials or small droplets of liquids are present. So the small particles of solid material present in air is known as particulated matters. And we know this as PM 2.5 and PM 10, because these are the two different size of particles which are measured by the environmental department. And you may see in news the level of PM 2.5 and PM 10 is so and so. Then lead. Lead is again very dangerous to all type of pollutions, air and water both, and even for the land contamination. So the combustion of fuel is also a bigger contributor for this lead pollution. Now, natural sources of air pollution. You may see the natural sources, which is the forest fires, volcanoes, vegetation and volatile organic compounds, bacterial metabolism, methane, dust, viruses and bacteria. These are the natural pollutants. And air pollution sources and effects. Sources types refers to natural and anthropogenic sources as well as additional subclassifications within each group. So this is anthropogenic pollution or man-made pollution. You can see here, this is source type, this is category, important sources kya hai. So you can look the important sources here and typical pollutants, which are the pollutants available in that. So combustion may be two types, stationary or mobile. Stationary means power plants, boilers, industry generators, diesel generators, municipal or industrial incinerators, and mobile motor vehicles, aircrafts. And these are the pollutants. You may look at these. Roasting and heating process. By this process, the non-ferrous metallurgical, ferrous metallurgical and non-metallic minerals. So on heating, these are the pollutants which are generated by this process. Now, chemical, petroleum, pulp and paper. So petroleum refining, inorganic chemicals or organic chemicals, you can see the pollutants These are the pollutants here. Food and agriculture. In food industry, for by food processing, crop spraying and dusting, and field burning, all these creates these pollutants. So types of particulates. The particulates are the solid particles present in air. So you can look at this the term, the meaning of the term and the example. So aerosol means general term. Aerosol is used for particulates suspended in air, means solid particles present in the air. These comes from the spray from pressurized cans. Mist aerosol consisting of liquid droplets, which is such as sulfuric acid mist. Dust aerosol consisting of solid particles that are blown in the air or are produced from larger particles by grinding them down. This the source will be, or example will be, dust storm. Smoke aerosol consisting of solid particulates and mixture of solid and liquid particles produced in chemical reactions such as fire. Cigarette smoke from burning garbage. Okay, now fume generally means the same as smoke, but often applies especially to the aerosol produced by condenser of hot vapors of metals such as zinc and lead fumes. So plume, geometrical shape or form of smoke coming out a chimney, this is called as plume. Fog, aerosol consisting of water droplets, is called as fog, which you see in winters mostly. And smog is a composite term which is prepared by the fog with smog, is known as smog. Major toxic metals and their effects. You can see the lead, major toxic metal, and these are the health effects. It is neurotoxic, affects blood system, behavioral disorders, and death. Cadmium, cardiovascular diseases, hypertension, interference with zinc and copper metabolism, kidneys are damaged. The nickel, combustion of coal, diesel, residual oils, it damages the respiratory system, lungs, and may produce cancer. Mercury, so it affects nerve and brain and damages the kidneys. Effect of air pollution on human health. Near about 50,000 people die every year prematurely from illness related to air pollution. Acid deposition, forest damage. If acids are created during rainfall while the oxides present in air dissolved in water creates the acids. So by the acid deposition, forests are damaged. Buildings and monuments are also badly affected by this acid deposition. Effects of air pollution on the stratosphere. Air pollution directly affects the stratosphere and it damages the ozone layer. You can see there's a hole in ozone layer on the North Pole, and it was affecting the human health on Earth. It was affecting the global warming was taking place, and this was also a region, one of the regions of the global warming. So ozone depletion, what does it do? Ultrasonic rays or ultraviolet rays directly reaches to Earth, or the more heat is reaching to the earth, increasing the temperature, and ultraviolet rays creating sunburn and cancer, and affecting the production of food grain on earth. So greenhouse effect, the chlorofluorocarbon or greenhouse gases are produced in nature, and these gases, due to industrial activity or natural activity, these are produced, and where these are in a lot of quantities, these makes a shield to the diffusing energy from earth surface to space. That energy is stopped by these greenhouse gases shield on the earth, and hence the temperature increases on earth, and this phenomenon is called as global warming, and this is affecting badly the earth environment. Air pollution control. Now, what are the measures by which we can control the air pollution? So first of all, the measures, we measures the pollution levels. So particulate matter, PM2.5 and PM10, we measures by this size of the particles, and we find out the level of the pollution. Now, reducing the pollution, we reduces the particulate matter, or we removes it, then sulfur removal, then nitrogen oxides removal, and this is possible by using staged burners or selective catalysts. Now, emission control equipment, the particulate control type, and second, gases and odors control type. So the basic mechanism of removing particulate matter from gas streams may be classified as: first, gravitational settling system, centrifugal impaction, inertial impaction, direct interception, diffusion, electrostatic precipitation. So first of all, gravitational settling chambers, you can see in this picture, this is air or dirty gas inlet, and this is clean gas outlet. Gases are entering in this chamber. Air volume is large, so all the particles, due to gravity, settles down, and these are collected here, and the clean air is discharged to the atmosphere back. Cyclone separators, you can see the cyclone separator. This is the cyclone separator, and this is the typical view of this cyclone separator. You can see the gas or dirty air is inlet here, and in this cyclone is there, or air is circulated, revolved, like the arrows are, you are seeing the arrows, like this air is blown, and by blowing this air, the particles are settled on the walls and collected at the base, and the fresh air is exhausted from here on top. Now, next is electrostatic precipitators. You can see two electrodes are there, larger electrodes are there, having charges negative and positive each. So you can see, while passing the electricity, the particles present in air are deposited according to their charge on both the electrodes, and these are settled down, and we can remove these easily. Wet scrubbers. Next is wet scrubber. You can see, as you are letting in the air or polluted air, then spraying water on the dirty air or polluted air, then all the particulated matter or other gases will be dissolved in water and it will be taken out from this end and the fresh air to the atmosphere back from this end. So this is wet scrubber. Now assessing air quality. So we assess air quality basis on air quality index. So air quality index 0 to 50 is good, 51 to 100 moderate, 101 to 150 unhealthy for sensitive groups, 151 to 200 unhealthy, 201 to 250 very unhealthy, 251 to 300 hazardous. So air quality is decided by the PM index, or you can see the PM10 and PM2.5. These two are the size of particles. PM10 is 10 micrometer dia of the particle, and PM2.5 is 2.5 micrometer dia of the particle present in air. So this unit of this PM index is microgram per meter cube air presence of the particulated matter. Now come to water pollution. Water pollution, you can see in this picture from industrial sewage, water pollution is taking place. This is the major part. But not only this, the household sewage is also equally responsible. And one more thing, or one more altitude of this water pollution is the chemical farming or the chemical fertilizers and pesticides utilized for agriculture. So all these are equally participating for the water pollution. As you can see, only 3% water is available, which is fresh water on earth. So if this fresh water is also polluted, then it's very difficult for our survival, and it directly affects our health and more dangerous than any other thing. Now you can see the all sources of water pollution. Household sewage here, this is industrial sewage, and this is farming. So all these three altitudes are equally responsible for water pollution. Now causes of water pollution, you can see the pathogens present in water are the major reason of the water pollution. Human waste contains concentrated pollution population of the coliform bacteria, such as you can see, or you have studied already, Streptococcus bacillus, you know? Okay, these bacteria normally grow in the large intestine of human, where they are responsible for some food digestion and for the production of vitamin K. These bacteria are not harmful in low numbers. Large amounts of the human waste in water increases the number of these bacteria, which cause gastrointestinal diseases. So another category of the water pollutants is oxygen depleting wastes, which creates the lack of oxygen in the water. So these are the bacteria. For digesting these bacteria, biological oxygen demand increases of the water, or these bacteria consume the oxygen of water. So this is called as BOD, biological oxygen demand, for clearing these bacteria. Then anaerobic bacteria, these are the bacteria which doesn't require oxygen. So no any oxygen demand is affected by these bacteria. Then harmful chemicals are present in the water. So the aquatic life is difficult in presence of these chemicals. So for these chemicals, the COD or chemically oxygen demand will increase, and these chemicals will absorb the oxygen present in water. So more oxygen will be required for cleaning of the organic materials or chemicals. Now, radioactive substances. The materials which are radioactive or producing the radiation and directly affecting the health of average livelihood are known as radioactive materials, such as, you know, uranium, cobalt, and many other metals are which are radioactive and affect the human health directly. Now come to the next, that is thermal discharges or thermal pollution. The hot water or hot chemicals are discharged into the rivers or ocean directly from the industry. So it increases the temperature of water. So many species are died due to increase of the temperature, and it also damages the ecosystem of the area. Hence the biodiversity is also damaged by this thermal pollution. Oil is also a great pollutant, where oil is mined or transported by the vehicles. If oil spills are there, then it pollutes the marine water also in a large area. So this is also a bigger cause of pollution. Control measures for preventing water pollution. So we may control the water pollution by treating the discharges of industries before letting them go into the river, nala, or ocean. Second, reducing the use of chemical fertilizers and pesticides in agriculture. And third, treating the sewage or household pollutants before discharging into the rivers or ocean or ponds. Now, marine pollution. This is also a great problem. Marine pollution damages the species in the sea, as we have seen the oil pollution. So that oil, crude oil, or the wax present in the oil damages the species of birds and fishes inside the marine ecosystem. So it is also a great cause of pollution. We have already talked about the thermal pollution. These are the control measures for thermal pollution. Now come to the noise pollution. This is also a bigger problem in our society. Nowadays, noise pollution is also damaging the human health. So the frequency of noise above 80 decibel is harmful to us. 80 to 40 decibel, no any problem anyhow. So the noise should be under the permissible limit, and the frequency should be reduced if it is more in any particular area. So we have to see, look at the sources of noise pollution. So there are many sources of the unwanted sound. It may come from industry, operation of the industry. It may be from the vehicles, operation of the vehicles at highway, or it may be from explosives, explosion noise in mining area. So the effects of noise pollution on physical health. So it damages our hearing system and our nervous system. So noise pollution is not good for human health. So we have to make it in control. So the ambient noise levels in decibel zone wise. So in zone, daytime and night time. So in silent zone, daytime, the frequency should not be more than 50 decibel. At night time, the frequency should not be more than 40 decibel. In residential zone, the frequency should not be more than 55. And in night time, frequency should not be more than 45 decibel. In commercial zone, the frequency should not be more than 65 at daytime, and the frequency should not be more than 55 decibel at night time. In industrial zone, this frequency at daytime should not be more than 70 decibel, and the same at night time, 70 decibel. Noise control techniques for controlling this noise pollution. So there are some measures which may take for reducing the noise pollution. So first of all, we may reduce the noise at source. Then we may make a green area surrounding the noise source so that the noise going outside the premises is reduced very much. Then we may make green belt on the highways to reducing the noise pollution on highway. We may make walls parallel to highway to reduce the noise pollution, or we may strictly stop the blowing the horn in residential area, or we may shift our highways, or we may shift our highways away from the residential areas so that the noise pollution may be reduced. So you can study the different measures taken for stopping the noise pollution. Now, solid waste management. Classification of solid waste. First of all, you have to classify the solid waste, or you have to segregate the different materials, and after segregating them, you may use 3 R's. 3 R's means recycle, reuse, and recycle, reuse, and reproduce. So the plastic, metal, rubber, glass, and many more things may be collected, and if something may be reused, it may be reused. If some material is broken and it may be reprocessed, then it should be reprocessed, and then the reprocess using as waste material, and then we can reduce the solid waste, and after it we may process the municipal solid waste. So these are characteristics of municipal solid waste. You may see here. Now, control measures of urban and industrial waste. So we may control by reduction at the source, recycling and disposal. You can see it is given in detail and you may study it. Now come to hazardous waste. Hazardous waste means those waste which are hazard to the environment, such as the waste which may damage largely, such as radioactive materials or these hydrocarbons. These are also hazardous waste because these are highly inflammable and may damage to the property and health. So these are the characteristics of hazardous waste. You can see here. So this is all about the environmental pollution. The whole environmental pollution is now completed. So you may get benefited for this. Thank you very much.